Hey guys, here with a new Seether lesson for you. This is going to be for the song Let You Down. So the song is in drop D, so grab yourself a tuner and let's get started. So strong structure is really cool because they take the same riff but change just variations of it, so it sounds different every time and flows really nicely. So to catch those differences, there's a tab in the description. Make sure to check that out, it'll help you out a lot. So this is the basic riff for the intro of the song. It starts like this. So that's all on the top string. It's open second fret. To the fifth, and then hammer on 7/5. Just slide to the five and pull off. So all together, slow, that's. And we do the same thing, it's just instead of just playing the top string and palm muting, we're gonna play the whole chord and balls out. So. There's a little lead thing that goes on, and it's all octave chords, and it's going to sound like this. So all it is mimicking what the other riff is doing. It's that E up here, and you're bending it so it sounds like you're going a semitone higher. And then dropping it down to the D. Then we're going up to the 10th and 12th frets. Same sort of octave chord. To the D. Then the 10 and 12. 12 and 14. 10 and 12. Then the same sort of thing. To the 12, 10 and 12, then to the D. And you fade out. So that one more time, slow, all together. And then the verse, you already know it because it's that same intro, just. Then there's a little bit of a change when it goes to the pre-chorus, and it's And all it is instead of starting at the two like we did in the verse and going, I'm starting with an open string. So it's. And then we go right into the chorus. So the chorus, it's going to be just fifth chords. It's going to be a E, G, D, C, A, and G. So I'm going to play that slow. Just check it out. It goes like this. So it's just sliding in between it. Like I said, check it out in the tab and that'll show you the rhythm a little bit better. Then it goes through that one more time. And the only thing that changes is the ending. So that how that'll go is like this. Mm-hmm. dark chord. It's a flattened A with a flattened fifth, I think it was called. And we go right back into those parts that you already know. And that doesn't really change until we get to that cool part right before the going into the bridge. And it goes up. So that's hammer-ons and pull-offs 5 to 0. 5, slide up to 8. 0. 2s. 2, slide up to 5. Pull-off to 0. So slow that's. At the end of the other one. The only difference when we come in full band is there's slight variations with how you play it. Check out the tab because it'd be easier than me trying to explain it to you and confuse you. But I'll play through that once just so you can see here. 2, 3, 4. Like I said, check out the tab. And then just the regular chorus you already know. There's also a lead line in the chorus. It's really simple, but I really love the way Seether works in their leads because it just really, it's pretty simple, but it adds a lot of character to the song. So check it out. For this, I turn on a little bit of delay usually, just to make it sound full and in case you hide any little mistakes. But right now I'll do it without it just so it isn't confusing. It's gonna be all on the G string, and it goes. And that's it. So that's 9, slide to 12, back to 9, back to 12, slide to 14, slide to 12. You do that 2 times and then same beginning. Only now you slide to the 16. To finish things off. So that slow would be like this. And that's it. So let's put that all together.